quick introduction to myself first. I'm Richard from SMD, Structural Metal Decks. I've worked for Structural Metal Decks for the last 4 years, in which case we've seen a new MD take over. And he's, you know, he's keen on working on our values. One of our values is safety and the other is innovation. Part of that, I've been encouraged to be heavily involved with our trade associations related to our, you know, our industry, which is FACIT, UK Metal Decking Association and the BCSA. So we've got heavy involvement in health and safety committees, board membership as well. So we're heavily involved with that. SMD, just a quick overview on who we are as a business. We're a business established over 30 years ago now. We specialise in the delivery of structural floors and roofing solutions. We're quite unique in our approach to a lot of people in our marketplace in the fact that we do everything from the design, manufacturing, right through to the installation on site. We've got facilities that we've started in the UK, we've also got facilities in the Middle East and India. We're involved in some of the UK's, what I would say, prestigious builds over the last few years. So our locations, our head office is based down in Poole, in Dorset. We've got a logistics hub that's based just north of Nottingham, and we've got a satellite office up in Coatbridge in Scotland. We're involved in contracts, we employ guys directly throughout the whole of the UK, so we're spread all over. The services that we provide, just a quick overview, we detail all of our own decking designs around the steel frame models, so we're heavily involved in AutoCAD and BIM design. We manufacture our own decking in-house. We've got a manufacturing plant that's based just near to Leeds. And then the site installation side, which is the bit that I look after. So we do everything from our own safety netting in-house, which involves the net inspections, then the actual installation on site. We then work above those nets to install the metal decking, which you can see something cut there. We also have our own stud welding fleet, which are the stud welding lorries that drive around the country installing shear studs. And then we complete the package by putting the concrete flooring on as well. This is just a whiz through of some of our builds that we've been involved with. So we're involved in the Shard a little while ago, and also the Mayor's Office. The Olympic Village we were heavily involved in. The O2, we've just finished a project within the O2, Project Mint, and we're just about to take on another project within the O2 Dome. And the Etihad Stadium, the extension recently undertaken. So we've won the award today for innovation, which, as I said before, is one of our core values within the business. The nomination that put forward for ourselves included the following items. So TGNMI, which is our technical guidance note, which was referred to. Over the years, we've built like a library of questions for both technical and for health and safety on site. And you know, we're heavily involved in trying to influence and change our industry that we're involved in for the better, for health and safety. Now, part of these, you know, on our website, we've got plenty of documentation that anyone can download about the correct installation ourselves. We're really transparent as a business. But part of that, we thought we'd evolve our technical guidance manual, which was always a printed hard copy version. You could download it onto PDF. However, it's a large document, which wasn't easy for people to access the information. So we developed a Wikipedia style page, it's basically that document split down into searchable headings, very, very easy to use, much like Wikipedia. Now, as and when queries or issues come up that we have to address or overcome, or industry improvements, we can then upload it live rather than waiting for documentation to be updated and issued out. So we strive ourselves quite differently from a lot of our competitors in that way. And I say that's free for anyone to browse or look at on our website, which you can see the link there. The other thing that we looked at this year, over the last 12 months, was trying to reduce manual handling with our site operations. Now, historically, packs were positioned at the start of the bay, and obviously the guys had to split these packs out and manually lift them and put them into place. We did a bit of an exercise with our site teams and some of our construction managers to look at what their thoughts were, what people actually installing it, what they thought was the best practice for us to undertake. We had varying responses. But then actually when we started looking at the data that was coming back in, there was one way of reducing manual handling by quite a substantial amount, which was to position the packs in the middle of the bay. meaning that you're only spitting the pack in two directions rather than just lifting one out and working out. And we actually found out that that reduced manual handling by about 30%. So not only it's better for the occupational health of the guys, less manual handling, but also better proficiencies with time and productivity on site. So again, just looking at something very simple, we find that you can see the differences in the distance travelled on that graph there. But yeah, we found that it was massive benefits from that just by challenging something that was industry norm previously. We've also developed interactive health and safety reporting for all of our construction managers. They're all given tablets now, and within our Connect system, which is a bit of an intranet system, we've developed an on-site safety documentation that is very easy to run through. We attach photos to it, which is something new that before it was always paper copy. We now get live reports from this, come straight through to me, so as soon as anything's happened on site or the report's been raised on site, the copy comes straight to me, and the stats that we can collect from this at the end of each month, we can look at what areas we need to hone in on improvements in terms of health and safety. So it's turned out very beneficial for us. And lastly, in trying to engage with our workforce further, we've always sent out health and safety alerts, we've always sent out paper copies, the rest of it. In this day and age, I'd like to think that they're all red, but I don't think they are. But so we're trying to think of how can we engage, how can we get quick messages out to our guys. So we've engaged with a website that's automated text service. We've pre-populated that for a 12-month period so that every Wednesday at 12 o'clock, every one of our employees gets a text alert to coming through to their phone. So it's just little quick one-liners to say, remember, different messages as we're going through. Just a quick reference to keep it fresh in their mind. Let's be thinking about health and safety. Let's be thinking about what we should and shouldn't be doing. And that's pretty much it from me.